two, one, two, three, four. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again.
Welcome to the channel. Today's video is about screwdrivers. I love screwdrivers. In fact, I'll be having screwdrivers for dinner tonight.
Recently saw this lot of screwdrivers on sale for $9.99 on eBay. And usually I'll mark it to look at later, but sometimes I forget about them. So I bid $9.99, and all of a sudden one day I got this notification, I won. And what a buy it was. Look at these beauties. It's nice. It doesn't have a brand, but we got a nice band around here and a metal end for the ferrule. Beautiful wooden handle. It's chattered and rough. It's going to need some work, but the shape is good, and really nice design. It's got a hex shank here. You can see the facets here, down to a round small shank, and then a screwdriver tip. And this evidently at one time had been ground down, so it's lost some of its area there, but it's still a functioning screwdriver. But overall, this is one nice screwdriver. And wood, metal, brass, hey, just my style for refinishing. The next one was an interesting design, too. This screwdriver's got the hex shank, and it's got a I don't know if this was the original ferrule or not, but it looks like it. It looks like it, which is brass, unusual-looking one. The handle's got a really nice design with the grooves in it here. Here again, no name I can find on it anywhere. I don't have any idea of what brand, but really a nice looking screwdriver. And as a bonus, then on the end, there's the end of the screwdriver, but a brass ring around the end of it here. So real nice design with the wood, the brass ring here, and the brass ferrule, and an unusual design, the nice hex shank. Next is a cabinet screwdriver, I call them, with this tight blade. And it's a fairly basic one with just a rustic handle on it, and what looks might be a brass ring around it here. When I get it cleaned off, I think that is brass underneath there. The only thing about this is the offset. The blade is offset. It's almost like this was a handmade screwdriver. I don't know. And it's, of course, it's curved. You can see that. It's bent and wavy, I'll call it. And then this little off-centering on the blade. But that could be fixed into a nice screwdriver, too. And lastly, with this little, another cabinet screwdriver. And beautiful design on this handle here. Nice ferrule design and the blade on it here. Everything in pretty good shape. The only thing about the handle is on the back end here, it's chipped and broken off, chattered. This thing had just been well used. But I guarantee you when that's finished, it's going to be nice. Got some beautiful wood here. Beautiful wood. And feels good in hand. Nice screwdriver. So we'll get to work and clean these up, and we'll have some nice classic items. And just done an expansion in my tool wall, so I've got some screwdriver racks ordered and some other things. I'm expanding it out a little bit. Don't have a lot of extra room. Actually had to move some cabinets to do it, but once I get that done, I'll be able to get the new wall up and I'll do a review on it. Okay, I'm ready for the reveal on the screwdriver restore, but I made one little modification in here. This one screwdriver, which is this one, I replaced with another. This was just, I don't know. Looks like the whole thing was handmade and this blade is offset in here. I'm going to either have to try to find a way to modify this, put a new handle on it or do something. So this will be parts for now till we can get some kind of completion on it. Instead, I replaced it with this screwdriver. I'm going to show you a short video on this screwdriver now to show you what it's all about. It's just now added to the haul. Here's an unusual screwdriver. Haven't seen one like this before. The handle is wood, and then the very tip of it here is acetate. You can see the... it's actually dirty and hard to see, but I'm sure that'll clean up to a nice amber color. The handle with a nice design. The ferrule is in bad shape. I don't know if somebody... it's mashed and mangled. And it looked like somebody tried to take it off, but didn't get it all the way off, so they... kind of mess with it here, so gonna have to do some repair on this. It won't even fit back on here. I don't know why it got so mashed up, but the tip is in the shape of the tip's pretty good. There's a little bit of bend to it, but it's an unusual tool with the acetate just on the end here. So I'm gonna give that one a clean up and see what we can put together. Now I'm ready for the reveal after I replaced the terrible screwdriver with another one that needed a lot of work on it, the one with the acetate tip. And so the collection's all ready to be reviewed now. First of all is this screwdriver that was in really bad shape. The wood was really bad. Had to take a lot, sand a lot of the wood off to get it to some good material. And of course a lot of patina and pitting and staining on the metal parts. So here's what we did to get this one up to standard. And as you can see, the amazing difference. I sanded and polished all the metal on here, including the brass ring on here. And took the handle down quite a bit with the sanding and put red oak stain on there because it looked like the right stain to use to bring out the color I wanted in the handle. Just a beautiful screwdriver. I'm just really pleased with it. There's the before and after. Next was this screwdriver. It was a little kind of an odd item for a couple of reasons. One, it had, after I got it all cleaned up, it was a brass ferrule. And this other ring was a copper ring. It wasn't brass. So you had brass here and brass here. And this copper ring on it too, which looks out of place. And this ferrule looks like a brass fitting of some type. Like it could have been a plumbing fitting. It looks like it had been worked on some here. So I don't know what had happened to this during its life. The shank had a lot of pitting in it, so I took a lot out and didn't get it as nice as I wanted, but I think I got it down to a pretty good shine now. Shined up the brass and the copper. Still don't understand the copper ring. The handle, I probably could have done a little better. I didn't sand it down. I cleaned it and refinished it, but I didn't sand it down, and I may still do that because I'm not happy with how this turned out overall. I think it's still could use a little work, so I'll call it a half restore at this point. I'll probably take this wood back. It had a lot of dents in it. You can see around it, in it. And I didn't know how well that would do, but if I sanded this down, what happens to the brass ring? It's going to be oversized compared to the handle, so there's that decision you got to make sometime as to how far you go. This was an interesting item, the screwdriver with the acetate tip and the ferrule that was absolutely ruined, banged up, bent up. Somebody had tried to get it off and didn't succeed, and succeeded in damaging it. So here's the restoration on this one. And I got this ferrule as straight as I could. It's still got a few bumps in it, but I couldn't get anything in there to get it straighter. I got as straight as I could, but you'll see side by side how that nice acetate tip shows up. The only bad part is like an air bubble inside there that was during the manufacturing. Once I got this cleaned off, as you could see, couldn't even see through it. But as I got it cleaned off and polished, you could see that big imperfection in there. It's a shame because it's a beautiful little screwdriver. This part had been painted and was a black color, and I didn't like that. I did sand the wood down and put a stain on it. Refinished the metal. Got the ferrule as straight as I could. So there's the redo on this screwdriver. And lastly was probably the best one of the bunch. And this did turn out great. As you can see, this end was broken off, chewed up. I don't know what on that end. So I got it sanded down and smoothed out. Took the metal and did a lot of work on it to get it. Here it is on a side-by-side. Guess you can't see it. I didn't have it framed right, so we'll put it over this way. But again, with the metal cleaned up and with the new finish on here, that handle just turned out outstanding. Love these little screwdrivers, cabinet screwdrivers. They just turn out to look so nice, and I believe this was, looks like it was in the cabinet screwdriver category, except for the tip was kind of small, so I'm not too sure about it, and the length was a little long. But great batch, great haul. It's a lot of fun to take these and really bring them back to a nice condition. I'll probably redo this one some. That's a finish. That one's ready to go. In fact, I got spots on the wall for all of these when I did my wall restoration. I added another screwdriver rack, so it was room for 6 more screwdrivers. So these plus some out of the drawer, and it'll be ready to really show off on that portion of the wall. Thanks for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed the screwdriver restoration.